Over 15 million Americans suffer from osteoarthritis of the knee. In fact, our American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons has indicated that it's one of the leading causes of disability worldwide. The reason that people develop osteoarthritis of the knee is multifold. Probably the most critical factor is family history. One of the other factors could be lifestyle and activities. A lot of people that enjoy active lifestyles may have a propensity to develop arthritis in their knee joint, particularly if they have had prior injuries. Partial knee replacement's been out for a long time. So the topic we're discussing isn't anything that's new. It's just this treatment option is more revolutionary or forward-thinking in terms of the technology that we're using, and that's MAKOplasty. MAKOplasty is robotic-assisted partial knee replacement surgery that utilizes a robotic arm in conjunction with a surgeon interactive technology to accomplish partial knee replacements. One of the great features of this is that we can use smaller incisions and less soft tissue damage in order to facilitate a quicker recovery and quicker return to recreational activities and work even. The difference is with partial knee replacement surgery, we can selectively replace one or more of the different compartments inside the knee joint. So one of the ones I see most typically is a medial partial knee replacement where just this compartment is replaced. It's also possible to just replace underneath the kneecap this articulation vis-a-vis a patellofemoral arthroplasty or the lateral compartment, which is the outside here. That's unique from total knee replacement, which replaces all three compartments. And one of the biggest features about that is that with partial knee replacement surgery is you can retain the cruciate ligaments. So in total knee replacement, at least most of the time, the anterior cruciate ligament is always removed or sacrificed, in addition to which the posterior cruciate, which is another supporting structure of the knee, is removed as well. One of the main benefits of MAKOplasty or partial knee replacement surgery is those main ligaments are preserved. What our hope is that by preserving the ligaments and less soft tissue damage, less soft tissue exposure, less bony resections, is that the outcome will be a knee replacement, a partial knee replacement that feels more like a natural knee. When a patient arrives for surgery, they're greeted at the patient intake area and they're brought into the staging area where they're prepared for surgery. Each one of these rooms is individual, and it's there that you will greet your anesthesiologist, your circulating nurse in the OR, and your surgeon. The average time of surgery is about 1.5 to 2 hours. The goal is, if at all possible, that a patient will have physical therapy the same day of surgery at least once, if not twice, and then once or twice again the following day before being discharged home. The average person is able to return to work within a relatively short period of time. I would average between 2 to 4 weeks. I would say 90% of people are back to work by about the 4 week period after partial knee replacement. So the way this happens is for patients that are candidates for partial knee replacement surgery, part of their preoperative workup is that we refer them for a CT scan. And that CT scan actually catches imaging involving the femoral head, the knee, and the ankle joint. So this technology actually allows us to create a three-dimensional model on a computer and then figure out the sizing, the orientation, and position of placement for the implants to try to ensure as good a result as possible. One of the key features about this technology is that it uses this new science called haptics, which is the ability to use sensation or touch to form a boundary. And what this means is that the cuts are defined in a set boundary of an allowable space. So the burr on the tip of the robotic arm can only cut where it's supposed to. If you reach the edge of the boundary, it will stop. One of the ways I think that this technology has enhanced my practice and ability to take care of patients is, again, to reproducibly get excellent or precise results. To be able to position the implants where I want them with a high degree of certainty on a reproducible basis. So this is the Mako robot. As I said, it weighs over 1,000 pounds. And this is the robotic arm, which has very fluid movement. You can see it's controlled or anchored to the robot. At the end of it is a 6 millimeter burr. And this burr is what we do all the cutting with. We position it adjacent to the table where the patient's on, and we use information about the robot's location and the arm location. Now, the way this information is conveyed is through these arrays, which are attached to the robot, This appendage has these arrays which beam information to the infrared camera. We attach to the patient two sets of arrays as well, using pins. In this fashion, we're able to send information that's fixed to the patient up to the infrared camera, which then inputs it into the computer. And that way, we're able to know where the leg is and where the knee is in three dimensions in space, as well as the robot to know where the knee is in three dimensions in space. I have these specialized probes which I use during the surgery. And these probes have a very defined tip, and they also have arrays attached to the probe, which is allowed for me to beam information from here to the infrared camera, which is then put into the computer. All this data is compiled in the computer, so that gives me a real-time feed in three different dimensions about where the knee is in space and where I'm going to position the implants. So in depth, angles, all that can be confirmed real-time right here in surgery using this instrumentation.